Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new, kindly subscribe, and for my returning subscribers, thank you so much for your support. So guys, in today's video guys, I'm going to show you how to prepare mehendi paste or henna. Yeah, henna guys, this plant you are seeing here is called henna. So this henna guys is almost in every Indian compound. Like I've never seen a compound without this plant. It's almost all over. Even at the roadside, you will see it. So that shows how important the plant is. So guys, this is the henna. You normally hear henna powder and all that. So this is the plant. So today I'm going to show you how to prepare from start up to the application part. So it's easy to plug the leaves. Just hold tight with your fingers and then pull it. Just like that, yeah. And don't worry about the plant, it will grow back. It grows really fast. I'm picking it from the ground because these ones, they look tender, and it will be easy for me to make it into paste, to blend into paste. So they normally actually blend. There is a special rock. Traditionally, they will roll. As if you are rolling a chapati, but on a rock. You put it there and then add some lemon juice, and then they will crush it using the stone, the big rock. But because we are not going to do that, I will just use blender. So guys, this is the plan. It's just in my compound, what am I saying, my landlord's backyard. So that's why I'm always picking it from here. So I always pick it. I use it for my fingernail and for my hair also. It's really good for hair. It makes hair strong. If you have gray hair, it's also good for dyeing gray hair. It's a natural dye, and it protects hair from breakage also, because it gives that extra protection. Yeah, so after picking, I will wash and put in a separate sieve so to drain some extra water, so it can be runny after blending. So guys, this traditional mehendi, it's used by Indian mostly during wedding, any function. They will put it on their palm, on their fingernails, and also the arm, also the hand, and the sole of their feet. Guys, we are going to blend. So the reason for putting this is for its cooling effect. It has a cooling effect, so especially if it's hot during summer. See the consistency, it's really good. It's not runny, it's not watery, and it's not too hard. So that's the concept. I just use some lemon juice, just half of a lemon juice. That's what I squeezed inside it. So it's ready to use. Transferred into this plate, this bowl, because it will be easy for me to use from here. So guys, the reason why they use it is for the cooling effect. It has really cooling effect. If you apply on your palm, you feel that cooling effect, like as if you put really cold water on your palm. So that's the reason they normally put, especially you know, during wedding, the bride will be tensioned and everything. So they do the ceremony before wedding. To apply mehendi, all the women will apply mehendi on their palm, and the bride also will apply the mehendi to ease tension. So they believe that it helps to relieve the nerves on their body. The nerves on their palm and their sole of the feet of their sole, and in that day of the wedding, the bride will be less tensioned. So that's why they apply. And another thing also is decoration. So guys, this simple design I just draw. I'm not an artist, guys. I'm just trying. But guys, Indians are really, really good in this. Yeah, like they don't even like they are so good. They're used to it. It's like they just they transfer it from one generation to another generation, so they are really good in artwork. Whether they went for school to do art or they didn't go, they are all the same. They really know how, this is basic thing for them. But for me to draw this flower, it took me time. Just for illustration though, I didn't even, it's not as nice as if an Indian person was to draw my palm. So after putting on the palm, they will put on the fingernails, and not only the fingernails, but some few inches beyond the fingernail. They all like the fingernail, around the fingernail. That's how they will put generously. They will heap it on top and also around, just the way I'm doing here. It's really cold. So during summer, this one is good. If you are feeling heat, you are sweating, just put it on your head. You will be feeling chill, and it's really calming. So it's really good for health. So that's it, guys. Yeah, I think I'm done. So finally, that's how it came out. So I left it here for like 30 to 45 minutes. But most people, mostly they normally leave overnight. It dries fast. It really dries fast. So that's the end results, guys. I just play with it by writing my name there. Just see, it's not a permanent stain though. It's temporary. It can stay for like maybe a week, something like that, and then for the nail it grows together alone. But if you stay with it overnight, guys, it will come out really, really dark. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much for being with me. Thank you. Bye bye.